For after two public hearings and 10 intense technical working groups, we are finally able to move forward with this measure along the trail blazed 10 years ago, when the late Senator Edgardo Ongara filed a substitute bill during the 15th Congress that sought to institutionalize inclusive education through special education in all public and private elementary and secondary schools nationwide. Truly, this legislation has long been a long time coming. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I can tell you from firsthand experience that Inclusive Education Act is going to change the lives of many of our countrymen in a big way.
I'd like to commend our very hardworking chair of the Committee on Basic Education, Senator Nguyen, for sponsoring and authoring this measure. I also filed Senate Bill 329, and I thank him for including taking that into account in the finalization of the committee report. And I truly believe that he is doing a great job as our chair, as is our chair of higher education, Senator Joel. In fact, they have really looked through the work of the EDCOM, which was started by my father back in the 80s and 90s, and the unfinished work, yung recommendations like the teacher council, inclusive education, more access, they are carrying this to fruition. And I really, really admire them and commend them for that, Mr. President. And this should finally put to rest the rumor that the gentleman from Valenzuela is only compassionate towards the opposite sex, Mr. President. This proves that he is really compassionate to all sectors of our country, particularly the disadvantaged. Salamat po, Mr. President. Salamat, Mr. Sponsor.